Hello once again, guys. Buzz Killington here, and just a quick video today talking about the blessings of Khorne. As we all know, the World Eaters are on the way and their first character is coming later this month. So I thought I'd take the opportunity to take a look at the faction trait and have a little discussion about how I feel it can be best utilized. So yeah, the blessings of Khorne, it deals 3% more damage and receives 8% less psychic damage for each unit that was defeated in melee this battle. Makes sense, it works well with the bloodthirsty followers of Khorne. Excuse me. It doesn't sound much, but you realize it counts up to a maximum of 8 defeated units. So if you've got the full 8, that means you can have 24% more damage and receiving 64% less psychic damage for each unit that was so you're a Khorne worshipper, your World Eater, by the end of that, with all the benefits stacked, will be doing a lot more damage, and psychic units will barely be able to touch him. Tiark is going to be looking at this in complete envy. But yeah, so that's actually pretty damn interesting. How best can it be utilized? Let's look at a few units that World Eaters might synergize well with, just based off this alone. Okay, so in terms of synergies and how the Blessings of Khorne can best be utilized, obviously the thing to bear in mind is you're going to be wanting to rack up those melee kills as fast as possible. There are a few that come to mind for that. First up being our old boy here, Angrax. He, of course, is infamous for being absolutely deadly. If you plop him next to, say, a spawn point in Onslaught or in legendary events, he will just massacre everything that comes near him, thanks to his wonderful little passive, Hateful Assault, which allows him to batter them with power damage for the temerity of daring to leave combat with him. So he's a strong contender straight away. Another good choice might be Harkon Worldclaimer. Of course, the movement of 4, he's an absolute badass in his own right. He can get a lot of piercing damage done. And of course, he has his Herald of the Apocalypse. He can do a lot of piercing damage and remove armor as well. Pretty damn strong. And he is a good one to rack up early kills against lightly armored targets. So straight away, Rask, or indeed any World Eater would synergize really well with either of these two. There is potential for Arkham Artis, like, of course, he is a hated psyker, and Khorne has a dim view when it comes to psykers, but his ability to spam a lot of blood letters will be very useful. Of course, the blood letters can go and cause absolute havoc on enemy summons or things like that. Other outside possibilities are, of course, an unusual choice here perhaps, but might go well with Aleph Null. He can, of course, get in, deploy his scarab stake, and take out a melee target first turn relatively easily, and from then on they'll multiply and start biffing across the map, causing havoc. So yeah, another one, and this is an unusual choice from a lore perspective, but Brother Jaeger is actually an interesting choice here, because of course he has his nice little martial superiority and he gets to smack you around first. I've used him today in the first day of the Ragnar event, and he basically wiped out half the opposing force just by plopping him near the spawn points. They came in to attack him, he got to hit them first. He just wiped out an absolute ton of orcs. Really, really, really effective. Or was it Fallen Sons? Either way, he wiped out a ton of them. But yeah, his ability as well makes him pretty damn useful for stacking up the World Eaters' abilities. For all, it's a bit weird that the Black Templars and the World Eaters would be teaming up. This is Tacticus. Who cares about the lore in that regard, really? We just want results. Yeah, so obviously this ability makes Rask and other World Eaters and followers of Khorne pretty damn useful in things like legendary events and in things like Onslaught. PvP maybe to a slightly lesser extent, depending on whether you're up against a team that spawns a lot of summons. But yeah, the ability to just keep getting stronger, your world eaters to keep getting stronger as the kills get racked up, means by the time that he actually gets into combat as well, he's going to be particularly beefy. And of course, any kills by the world eater in question will also count towards that bonus. So yeah, you're going to want to field strong melee or maybe even exclusively melee based teams to make the most of the world eaters blessings of Khorne. And yeah, you'll just cause absolute havoc and reap a lot of skulls for the Blood God. So yeah, I'm going to be talking more about Rask in particular down the line, closer to his event. I'll be doing my normal character showcase, looking at his active and passive in a little bit more detail, and talking about potential synergies between him and other characters. But for a starting point, I think the ones that I've outlined are actually reasonably decent as far as getting the Blessings of Khorne going to full effect. All right, so yeah, that's it for the moment. Let me know in the comments what you think of what I've said, whether there are any other characters that you think might be particularly good for this. I'm thinking in terms of chaotic synergies primarily, but obviously I'm always open to other suggestions. And yeah, that's it for now. Until next time.